Last night after the WWE TLC pay-per-view, the one thought that crossed my mind was the WWE and World Heavyweight Champions are both pure wrestlers again. And that is just totally awesome, my book. The last time that two pure wrestlers with great wrestling ability were champion was at WrestleMania 20, when Eddie Guerrero and Chris Benoit both stood in the ring with the WWE and World Heavyweight title. Last night, Daniel Bryan cashed in his Money in the Bank contract against The Big Show after The Big Show won the World Heavyweight title from Mark Henry. And CM Punk retained the WWE title in a triple threat TLC match, which was incredible, by the way. And I began to think both of these men came through the roots of Ring of Honor and the very intense indie circle that they were in. And they personify what, starting from all the way to the bottom and rising all the way to the top, means. You know, a lot of these big muscle bodybuilders get a lot of stuff handed to them right away. You know, guys like Brock Lesnar, Dave Bautista, John Cena, they weren't wrestling very long until they got put on The Big Show. But CM Punk and Daniel Bryan, they wrestled for a long, long time before anybody ever gave them a big contract. And, you know, most people know Daniel Bryan as the American Dragon, Bryan Danielson. And CM Punk, well, he's always been CM Punk. But, you know, last night proved one thing to me, and that's that WWE is getting back to the art of professional wrestling. I mean, you see it in your champions. For example, your Intercontinental Champions, Cody Rhodes. Your United States Champion is Zack Ryder. And, you know, yeah, Zack Ryder is very gimmicky, but he's also a good wrestler. He also has unique things that he does. But your tag team champions are Kofi Kingston and Evan Bourne, Air Boom, which, you know, they remind me a lot of the Rockers and Shawn Michaels and Marty Jannetty and what they do in the ring. And your WWE champion is CM Punk, and World Heavyweight Champion is Daniel Bryan. And to me, it speaks volumes. You know, Triple H is running the ship now, and he calls a lot of the shots and what happens. And he's really proving that he wants to bring the art back to professional wrestling. And, you know, good for Triple H for doing so. He also had a great match last night with Kevin Nash, but I'm not going to talk about that. I just want to focus on CM Punk and Daniel Bryan. Like I said, they were two mainstays in Ring of Honor. Both have credible ability. Both have had great matches against each other, too. And I'm sure if you go on YouTube or Google it and type in CM Punk versus Bryan Danielson, you'll find some stuff. CM Punk is finally being allowed to be himself and be the person that, you know, he's wanted to be for a very long time, which is a great thing. Daniel Bryan, he's had his ups and downs this year, but, I mean, a lot of people are behind this kid. A lot of people love the beard, as he always talks about. But, you know, it's funny, when I was thinking about, you know, both guys last night, I created a photo with both of them in it, and it's called Honor Personified. And that was referring to the fact, yes, that they were in Ring of Honor, but they're bringing honor back to the art of professional wrestling. I personally, you know, I know a lot of people have been talking for the last few months and maybe over the last year now that the WWE and world title need to be unified. Well, I'll tell you this much right now. If that title, if those titles ever do become unified, the match needs to be CM Punk versus Daniel Bryan, and people will be treated to one of the greatest wrestling matches of all time. As like I said, the youth movement is happening in WWE. A lot of the younger guys like Wade Barrett, Jack Swagger, Dolph Ziggler, Sheamus, they're all starting to get in the spotlight a little more. And, you know, CM Punk and Daniel Bryan define everything that wrestling is supposed to be about. They got pretty good mic skills. I mean, CM Punk's a little ahead on the mic skills, but when it comes to wrestling ability, being able to tell a story and, you know, having unlimited ability in the ring, it really makes for a good match. It really makes for a good story. It reminds me a lot of, like, you know, the Bret Harts and the Mr. Perfects, the Ric Flairs, the Ricky Steamboats, the Chris Benoits, Eddie Guerrero's. I mean, Punk and Daniel Bryan are, you know, that this era's version of all those guys. Yeah, you have your John Cena, you have your Randy Orton's, you have your Miz's and guys like that who have dominating personalities and, you know, great physiques and whatnot, but they lack in the pure wrestling department. I mean, Orton, not so much. He's a really great wrestler. He's very talented. John Cena, though, you noticed last night that TLC did not have John Cena, and a lot of people are raving about how great the pay-per-view was. So, like I said, Daniel Bryan, CM Punk, my hat's off to you. I mean, the American Dragon, the Straight Edge Superstar, are your WWE and World Heavyweight Champions, respectively. And they are bringing honor back to those titles. They are bringing prestige back to those titles. And they should be very proud of what they're doing right now. And I hope come WrestleMania, it's not about The Rock and John Cena Foley. I hope, and my hope is, that's about CM Punk and Daniel Bryan defending their WWE and World Heavyweight Championships. And to me, that will be my highlight of WrestleMania 28, is to see both of those guys go out and defend their titles and defend them in really good matches. We've already heard that CM Punk is probably going to be wrestling Chris Jericho, and Daniel Bryan, we don't know yet. So, like I said, stay tuned, because it's going to be a great road to WrestleMania if both of these guys are still championed by them. And look forward to some classic wrestling matches and some old school fun again. So those are my thoughts on CM Punk and Daniel Bryan. Except congratulations to both men. They both deserve. But, you know, they both deserve all the success and credit in the world. So, like I said, stay tuned. You know, the road to WrestleMania is starting to kick off. And we'll see if the American Dragon and the Straight Edge Superstar can survive that road.